Hey guys, today I want to show you all of the pots that I got in the last couple of days, mostly from Ross, and there are a couple from IKEA. Because I've been propagating so many of my plants, I'm starting to worry that I won't have enough pots to put them in, and so anytime I see a good deal on pots, I make sure to just buy up everything that I can see. In my previous videos, I show you that I buy most of my pots from Marshalls, TJ Maxx, Ross, but I've noticed that in the last few months, or maybe just this past season, because there's this huge like boom in plant aficionados, I feel like Marshalls has been raising their prices on their planters. They've always been very reasonably priced there, but like I said, I've found that in the last season, they've been increasing their prices sometimes as much as twice of what their normal or previous prices were on certain sizes. So in this first set, I don't really like to have matchy-matchy things, and so I do plan on giving some plants away, and like I've mentioned before, I like putting them in these decorative pots because they just look a lot nicer when you present them that way. So here's a small pot that can probably hold a nursery pot size of a 4-inch pot, or maybe a 3.5-inch nursery pot. And the nice thing about this is that it's got a drainage hole at the bottom, as well as a lip or a saucer. And so that little one was $2.99. This one is $4.99. I think the biggest one there, which may be about an 8-inch pot, is I think $6.99, if I remember correctly. Yes, it's $6.99. So these are very reasonable prices, because if you go to even your big box stores like Lowe's and Home Depot, a pot of that 8-inch size will run you probably, I want to say like $30 or so. So this is a steal to get them at these prices. And I was really surprised to find them at Ross at these prices, because now, like I said, this little guy that you see here at Marshall's and at TJ Maxx, they're starting to price them at about $5.99, which is, I mean, that's still not bad for a little pot, but because I'm so used to getting them at such cheaper prices, I'm just in a little bit of a sticker shock. I've been buying planters from these stores for several years, and only in the last few years have they really been stocking a lot of these, and so it's really interesting to see just the different prices in fluctuation, how the prices fluctuate throughout time. I also noticed that Marshall's has kind of an issue with the consistency of their pricing. So I know that they probably just categorize all of their items in like kitchenware or kitchen utensils, or, you know, big category, general categories like that. And so I find that sometimes I'll pick up an item. So for example, a drawer organizer, you know, those ones that are made out of, not plexiglass, I forget what that material is, but it's like those clear drawer organizers. So one of those will be like $4.99, and then the next one that I pick up will be $5.99, even though it's the same price, or sometimes even twice the price of the other item, even though they're exactly the same. So you just kind of have to look out for that, I guess. So these, I know some of these are a tiny bit flashy, and they may not be to your liking, but I like them, and they do go with, I have a lot of mixed metals, or, you know, I have all kinds of like gold, silver, hardware all throughout my house, so nothing's really that matchy-matchy, which is why having all of these different types of planters are okay. But what I love about this one so much is that it's got these adorable little feet at the bottom. How cute is that? I remember a few years ago when Ross and Marshalls carried a whole bunch of these like hammered looking vaseware and pots. So now it's like the hammered look has inversed, and so now It's like embossed now. I don't even know if I'm making sense, but anyway, I just found that interesting because they kind of go with a whole bunch of stuff that I already have. So this is really nice. I think that I don't really like or have too many gold things in my house. I do have some, but I just bought a plant stand, or actually, it's more so of a side table that I'm repurposing as a plant stand. Look at this, $3.99. That's a very good deal. Anyway, I think it'll look really good with that. And of course, I'll show you a clip of that plant stand later in this video. So the rest of these pots, unlike the first three that I showed you, don't have any drainage holes. I prefer having drainage holes, but I can't always find them, especially not at prices like these. So, oh well. Here's the plant stand I was talking about. And so I like this because, like I mentioned, I don't have a lot of gold in my home except for that super gold planter that you see there with the philodendron. But anyway, that's what I mean. It's like I've been hoarding all of these pots, right? And they're all kind of, at least they all tend to go together, I guess, is what I'm trying to say. But I really love this plant stand. I'll call it a plant stand, even though it's more so of a side table. And it was only $30, $29.99 or something like that. And it is, I don't know how tall it is, but this was the smaller of the two. And I went to two different Ross stores, and these were available at both of them. So maybe, I don't know, they have them widely available across all of their stores nationwide, perhaps. But I really like this one because it doesn't get in the way of my heater vent. And so I like having something over that anyway, because sometimes my dogs like to run around and they knock over that little plastic thing that redirect the air to come inside the home rather than just, you know, blowing upwards. And so I liked having something to block my fur babies from getting all over there. So anyway, these two planters right here that'll probably hold about a 4.5 inch nursery pot on the inside, these are from IKEA, and each of these are $5.99. They're not as cheap as the ones that I bought from Ross, but I really liked the pattern on them. They also had one available in this very bright Christmas red. I don't have any red at all in my house. I have a lot of oranges and, you know, yeah, like an orangey red, but this other one that they had was a straight up red. So I'm showing you what it's called in case you want to buy it online or go check it out for yourself. But like I said, they also have it in red and they have it in a smaller color too. And when I went to IKEA, they only had like six of those left. So hurry up and go check it out. This other thing that I'm showing you is not actually a planter. However, I'm going to repurpose it as such because, again, it's the same ceramic material. It's glazed inside and outside, and so I don't have to worry about moisture seeping out. So this is some sort of like utensil holder that you use in the kitchen. As you can see there, you can microwave it. I guess you can even use it as, I don't know. I don't know what you want to use it as, but I also peruse the kitchen area for these things because you can find some that are pretty cheap. So most of the pots that I got hold either, they're mostly like 4 inches or bigger. That little blue one that you see is probably the smallest one that I got. So, all right, guys, that is my haul for today. As I'm looking at it in the screen here, that is a lot of pots. I've also purchased a few others throughout the last plant pot haul that I posted, but I didn't bother including them because they're all kind of stacked up downstairs in my basement and I didn't want to bother getting them out, I guess. But anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video. Let me know in the comments below if you've noticed any of your Marshalls and TJ Maxx prices increasing like I have. Ridiculous. I refuse to pay more for these pots? Let me know in the comment below. Or am I just being super cheap? I don't know. But anyway, I hope you enjoyed that video. Hey, if you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe if you like these kind of plant chit chat type videos. I'll tell you where to get the best prices for your planters because I'm always on a mission. Oh, and I have checked out some thrift stores, but I find that a lot of their prices are also just as expensive as Ross and Marshall's. And I've even seen items from the dollar store that are like priced at $3. What's the deal with that? I don't think so, Goodwill. All right, guys, have a wonderful week. Till next time, bye.